What do you like, bro?
Amina Hussein.
Uh-huh. You see where I'm going to go?
Up.
You all can come down.
This will make it
better. Yeah.
Joseph.
The bishop himself.
So welcome to the museum.
Here we look at the bishop.
Welcome again to the museum. This here shows where Sir Walter Raleigh rediscovered the lake in 1595. The first set of people to settle here, they were the Amerindians. And he was going to El Dorado in search of gold. His ship had got a hole, he sailed in the village, 3/4 miles from here near the seacoast, where he met the Amerindians, and they had helped him caulk the ship, and he called it black gold. This is why they have the pot here with the gold. The Spanish had called the area Terra de Brea. And Tierra de Brea means land of pitch. And that is how we got the name of our village, La Brea. So you are now on the southwestern part of Trinidad in the village of La Brea. And La Brea means pitch or asphalt. Pitch is raw, asphalt is refined. So pitch have all impurities. And as soon as he takes pitch, it's asphalt and it's exported out of our country, mainly for road building and airport runway. Am I speaking too fast?
No, sorry.
Go to the head of the class.
This is the typewriter we used to use in the earlier days. Mm-hmm. The copier. In the earlier days, the heater.
You put pitch in your coal.
No, you put it in a coal pot and you put the water on it, in it, to steam press.
Okay.
The grinding stone, the coal pot, everybody can see?
Okay.
And the mortar. Come on. This is of the oil workers' strike at Point 14 in 1917 to 1937. The different This is pitch. This is the pickaxe. They used to use in the earlier days, manual labor. But that was a lot of hard work. So that method is now condemned and we are using machinery. This is what it looked like when they used to dig the pitch near the seacoast. And they used in a pickaxe. So they came out like 3 a.m, dug the pitch, beat it, put it on the street, and they had to find a vein. It was once run by the British. So the buckets were named after the Brighton Company. So it's the Brighton buckets. The asphalt has been exported throughout the whole wide world, mainly for road building, an airport runway. Those are the different streets in Port of Spain, the lighthouse, which is now the Leaning Tower of Port of Spain.
Could you explain what the Leaning Tower of Port of Spain signifies?
Okay. This was once used as a lookout. Port of Spain was once a fishing village. So all up to Independence Square, it had a seacoast. And they had the lighthouse so they could have looked out. But now it's the Leaning Tower of Port of Spain because all there is unreclaimed land. And those are different streets, Frederick Street, Chacon, Independence North, different streets in Port of Spain. Stallmeyer came from Germany, went to America, came to Trinidad. He went into the asphalt industry and also into the land industry. La Brea transited from agriculture to the asphalt industry. This is what the village looked like in the earlier days with the Amerindians. The Amerindians, those are artifacts from the Amerindians, pieces of the goblets. The first people the hummingbirds. In Trinidad, we have a lot of folklores and legends. The Amerindians, when their ancestor died, they always believed in reincarnation. So they used to worship the hummingbirds as their god. So you'll observe land of the hummingbird. Papa Boa, this is a folklore. In the earlier days, the hunters would go into the forest and they would kill several birds and they would kill several animals. And that would get Papa Boa very angry. That's a folklore in Trinidad. And Papa Boa would turn himself into a deer. And he would lead them out deep into the forest. He either leave them there to die or he married them to his wife.
Oh dear, oh dear.
The hunters to his wife. His wife was a panda of the waters. And that is Dead Dwarf's part. The giant slot, they found it out on the lake. It came from a South American country. In the earlier days, we had slavery. So we are coming out of the museum when you all are ready. Okay, we just have to wait on them. So you see? Three legs. California, Venezuela, Pacific, and Trinidad.
And it's one of those three anywhere.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Call him. One in Venezuela, one in Trinidad, and one in Los Angeles, California. Those are the three lakes in the whole wide world, but the one in Venezuela is Maracaibo. The one in Los Angeles, California, is Labrador Tappet. And this one in Trinidad is the largest. It's a natural deposit, the eighth wonder of the world, and they use it mainly for road building and airport runway.
Okay? So tell me, does that new goal in
there? No. Okay, watch your steps while we go down the stairs.
Big goal.
Hey, but how, so I saw some people come out like
that. Right. Oh. He was going by the pitch.
I didn't see it.
Mango there.
Could be Labrador, you know.
Mango there. Long mango.
Locus, yeah.
We're just waiting for the rest of them to come, right?
Okay.
So I will explain this table for you.
And honey.
This is what it actually looks like when they are mining the pitch. 75% of the lake is solid, where we can walk and where they can mine. When you're walking on the lake, you have to imagine yourself walking on sponge. 25% is liquid, which is known as the mother of the lake or natural bitumen. This gentleman went out on the lake in the year 1998, not wanting a tour guide. Tour guides and villagers pulled him out. This is what he looked like. They used a tub of kerosene mixed with diesel, clean his skin. My skin was burning him because his pores were clogged. And they then took him to the hospital. The doctors used a chemical to clean his skin. This is a byproduct, the record.
An LP.
And the 45. This is also a byproduct. Flash ban. This is pitch. Pitch is raw. Asphalt is refined. This is asphalt also, but it's known as pellets. This is how China wants it. This is locust or stinking too. The reason why we have the tamarind here is to show people the difference of tamarind and the stinking too, because people think the locust is stinking too. This is a butter they found out on the lake. This is a calabash they found out on the lake. The yellowish look is the sulfur. This is a shell. You all know this, jambi, the black and red seed, petrified wood. This is cashew, the cashew nut. This is the seed from the locust or stinking dew. This building is on a floating foundation. If they didn't have that building on a floating foundation, it would have fallen apart. Every time the land shifts, the PVC would shift and the toilets would back up. Let's go this way.
For some of us, could you explain what's a floating foundation?
Sure. A floating foundation, when they dig the hole, they use baskets with boulders, put it in it, and then cast it.
Yes.
People in the village is also building their homes on floating foundation. They are putting sea sand or red sand. So every land, time the land shifts, the buildings would shift it. The pitch would not affect it. The lake was a volcanic eruption. So the vein of the lake runs through the whole village. In people's backyard, there is pitch. Every time they mine the pitch, to the strength and vein of the lake, it affects the roads and also people's homes. This building here, you all will have to come out.
No,
it would not.
Because the grave's right in the middle of the town, right?
So it would not affect the grave because where the grave is, it don't have any pitch.
Oh.
The old grave is on a hill.
Okay.
Inside of the village, they build it on a floating.
Okay.
New Jersey, you call that area. This building was on a hill where the lamppost is. Due to the strength and vein of the lake, it pelted down. Right now it's just sinking. It was once used as a storeroom. It took approximately 45 to 50 years to reach where it is. So it's not moving no longer. It's just sinking. The door cannot open. Do you have any question?
What's inside of that building?
I was going to say that.
It has nothing in it right now, but before it was used as a storeroom for TSTT company. They stored all their wires and cables in that building when it was on the hill. Okay? Come this way. Everybody here?
That came up.
Yeah.
Yeah. How long ago?
Just 4 years ago.
Recently.
Now, a lot of people would say the pitch grew, but the pitch does not grow. The pitch refills itself. So, no one put this pitch here, this pitch just puts itself up. That's a cashew tree. This is a locust or stinking to a tree. That's a cashew.
Cashew nut.
That's a ficus tree, it's a shady tree. That's an almond tree, and you get a better view of the mango there, the long mango tree.
Do you have any labrigal?
Yes, we have labrigal. Look, you see labrigal in the schoolyard up there. That tree across the road, that's a labrigal tree.
Labrigal mango?
Yeah. When you suck it, the seed is very sour. This way. I have given you all the first set of the introduction up in the museum, so I would not repeat myself.
Okay.
Huh? No. Heliconias are bird of paradise. The orange flowers. Heliconias are bird of paradise.
Chosen by the PNM.
No, the PNM symbol, it's a youth family to the Balinese. They took the pitch from out on the lake and they place it on our pathway. They took the pitch from out on the lake where we have been a while and place it on our pathway. The heat of the sun melted it, it looks like a lava. In the wet season when the rain falls, if they hadn't done that, then we'd be walking through mud and water. Do you all have any question? Are you all okay?
It feels soft.
Yeah.
It feels kind of soft when walking in.
You have some people on the tour of that?
That's the same sort of people with you all.
Oh, the first group?
Yeah. They're speeding. You wanted to go and meet them?
No.
Okay. No, you feel it spongy. Like you're walking on sponge.
Yeah. I'm walking on sponge.
Come. Yeah. You're in Fels, it's cool. We stand in here. Okay, give me a semicircle. A semicircle.
A semicircle, please.
Have you seen Josephine?
That building, the cream building with the red roof, that's the pump house. The lake is like a basin. The pitch contains 30% of water, 30% of mineral matter, and 40% of bitumen. Whenever the rain falls, it adds water to the lake. When there are masses of water, they cannot mine the pitch. This is how they would pump the water out of the lake. It goes through those silver lines straight into the sea and rivers. They are fresh water, they are salt water, and they are sulfurated water. People swim in the sulfur pools, which have medicinal purposes. It's good for psoriasis, rheumatism, arthritis, skin diseases, mosquito bites, dandruffs. The water is of different colors because of the minerals. The better time to swim on the lake is in a wet season from July to December month. We are now in a dry season, so all the water that you are seeing on the lake is whenever rain falls. Do you all have any question? Are you all okay?
Yes.
So people are allowed to come and swim on it?
Yeah. Yeah. Those buildings across the lake, that's the refinery plant. Okay. That's Trinidad and Tobago Lake Asphalt Company, 1978 Limited. That company was formed in the year 1888 by Mr. A.L. Barber and some other businessmen. It was once run by the British. It's no longer, it's now run by our company. And the lake is state-owned. The buildings across the lake, those are other industrial estate. It have nothing to do with the lake. Let's go this way. They would survive in the fresh water. They would die in the sulfur water.
But you say it pumps out.
The water.
Yeah.
But they are fresh water. Remember I told you they are fresh water.
Yes.
They are salt water because the lake is below sea level.
Uh-huh.
And they are sulfurated water because of the minerals the pit contains.
Okay.
So the fishes and other animals would survive in the fresh water.
Okay.
They would die in the sulfur water.
Right, but I think what she was asking was, what does any of the water run out into the sea and cause problems?
Yes, yes, I explained that already. They pump it out into the sea and the rivers.
Yes, but does that cause problems for the...
The water is diluted when the rain falls. Remember I told you all the pits contain 50% of water? So when the rain falls, it adds water to the lake.
So, it's diluted.
Diluted goes into the sea. Okay.
Yeah. That goes out into the sea.
Mm-mm. It's too expensive. If you drop this.
No. It will crack the concrete. Because remember, the lake is a volcanic. The area, the village. What? A slipper? The red? They scraped there.
I see you have tractor marks.
Yeah. Those are the machineries that would go out on the surface of the lake to mine the pitch.
To mine the?
Pitch.
How often this happens?
They does not mine asphalt. They mine pitch. They work from Monday to Friday. They avoid working weekends and holidays. Those are the water lilies or nemeros. They open early in the morning, they close in the afternoon time. In Trinidad, we don't have crocodiles and alligators. We have caimans.
Yeah.
Caimans are found in the rivers and the swamp. They are family to crocodiles and alligators, but they are much smaller and their jaws are much narrower.
It's alleged that a caiman would have taken the little baby into Madeline Pond.
Yeah.
It's alleged.
Yeah.
When did that happen?
Well, a few days ago. Yeah. They had divers, several divers going underwater trying to find the baby.
Yeah.
All was put here. Yeah. You would know when you're on the lake. It will feel more spongy.
That might be why they don't allow swimming.
It's not deep enough.
Look at the impression in front of us. Where Vika had
it's
parked.
Dangerous.
And it went down. They had to pull it down.
It's acrimonious.
That would be why you can't swim there.
Okay, we come in here. Are you all okay? Am I walking too fast?
Something over there.
Something's moving?
Okay. You see the bubbles? That's a methane gas. If the methane gas and the hydrogen sulfide gas was not escaping, it was not safe to come out here. All the gases out here is diluted from the water that the pitch contains. As the gas and the water force itself through the gas pocket, cracks or crevice or geological fault lines are formed. If there's water, the water keeps it cool, so it expands. And that is what forms pools that you can swim in. This pool is a freshwater pool. The sulfurated water, the water is in different colors. It's green, it's brown. So you would see it as we enter the lake. And when we get deeper into the lake, you would smell a hydrogen sulfide gas, a rotten egg scent. The bottom comes up to the top, so the lake rotates itself very slowly. The age of the lake is Miocene years. It's millions of years. Pitch came from oil. The area of the lake is approximately 95 acres. The depth of the lake approximately 250 feet deep. And in reserve of pitch, it would last another 400 years, how they are mining it.
Excuse me?
Yeah?
What's a bubble?
That's the gas, the methane gas. So we are walking on the surface of the lake.
So did Sir Francis Drake make any amazing discoveries?
Sir Walter Raleigh.
Sir Walter Raleigh.
Yeah.
Excuse me. Do you have any explosions sometimes?
No, not. Is the gases people, will come up rapidly, but
people
no.
People are allowed to smoke here?
No. They are not allowed to smoke, but it would not have an explosion, but you will hear the gases coming up rapidly because of the gas pockets, which I will show you in the picture as we go along our tour. And if there's an earthquake, you feel nothing. You just hear the gases coming up rapidly. Okay?
Because of methane.
Yeah. If you have a matches, you let it, you see a flame goes out, but it is not safe to do because the surrounding of us contains that gas. It's very dangerous. Yeah. But because of our open atmosphere, it would not affect us. If we were in a closed room, then it would affect us. In the company gives their workers milk every day. So the milk washes their system out. So workers does not suffer from any ailment from the lake. Everybody in the village, natural causes. Pressure, sugar, stroke, heart attack. Nothing from the sulfur. This is what the cracks or crevice looks like when there are no water. So it's known as the geological fault line. Looking at a better picture. Geological fault line. So all the water in the lake is from the rain. When I spoke of the gas pocket, this is a gas pocket. When the day is very hot, you mash it, the water comes out, it's hot. But the grays of the protective covering, locally, we wow. call it elephant skin.
Wow.
And this is the pitch they would then mine. You see? See there? That's the pitch. That's the water the pitch contains. You can touch it. Go ahead.
You're scared.
You all have to be adventurous because you all are out on the lake.
Just feel like water.
See?
Yeah.
This is a gas pocket. So what we are walking on is the protective covering.
Like,
yeah. Come this way. Now I want everybody to stay with my footstep. Do not stray away from me. I will go slower.
How many tours you have?
Right now it's very slow, so this is my first storm coming out with for the day. Mm-hmm. But like July, August, mm-hmm. as a tour guide, you come out here 2-3 times.
So your peak time is?
July, August for Carnival, Christmas, Easter.
Okay, so summer and Carnival.
Yeah.
Now when
would you all like to stand here? Stay here. Stay there. You remember I told you all, 25% is liquid. This is a small portion. This is the mud of the lake on natural bitumen. This is like quicksand. You step in it, the more you struggle, the deeper you goes down. We lost animals here, birds, fishes, caimans would come out here. Because when the fishes are swimming, they also get stuck in the liquid when the day is very hot. The birds, it looks like water, and they dive down, they get stuck, they would die. Look at the yellowish, brownish look, that's the iron. So what I'm going to do, bring the stick to the group, and you take a picture of that. Hold it. Don't get it onto you. Because the day is cool, it's not in a liquid state. If the sun was very hot, it would have been dripping. Yeah. Okay?
No, I've noticed, like villagers here, they are free to come out anytime?
Yeah. They come out here anytime. Come this way. Stay on this pathway.
You have a lot of doubts here?
Yeah. We have a lot of hustlers. Everything that happens in other countries,
it happens here.
It happens in Trinidad. So you all can stand there. There are pools that you can swim in and pools that you cannot swim in. Pools that you cannot swim in, as the gas and the water comes up, you look for the oiliness on the surface. So when you cannot see the bottom of a pool, one time you know, stay away from that pool. Okay. Look at that. So it's also found in pools.
Wow.
This is also the mother of the lake on natural bitumen. So this pool is filled up with this liquid. Okay? Huh? If you dive in,
you're stuck.
So come this way. But I'm the Beverly boy. Come this way. Stay with me. Yeah, today we had rain all day. This pool is about 2-3 feet deep. He had asked how deep the pool is. That's what you write. Look at the color of this water. Everybody looking at me? This is a sulfur water. This is what people actually swim in. This pool contains iron sulfide. So this pool contain iron sulfide. Come this way.
You guys can swim, right?
Yes. Come this way. I don't want you going away from me. Come here. There are solid places that look solid, but it is not.
Okay, solid 7 is from the Brea.
This is what it looks like if they don't mine it. If they don't mine it, the pitch does not grow, it refills. So this is what it would look like. The protective covering would look crumpled. Yeah?
So when it has a sulfur water, that means it's not sticky? It's not sticky?
Yeah. I just showed you a sulfur pool, When you can't see the bottom of the pool, you have to look for the oiliness. One time you would know the pool is not safe to swim in. This is what I wanted to bring you. Where the last man.
The real stuff, guys.
Yes, you put it in a Ziploc bag. You break it, you share it. Okay. This is the raw pitch that I have in my hand. Those are the gas pockets. So what I had given you, look at it, smell it, the tree stamps, you squeeze it. You squeeze it, you will see the water and the gas. As the gas and the water force itself through those gas pockets, cracks or crevices or geological fault lines are then formed. This is the last place they mine. They strip mine the pitch. Listen. Come, sir. They strip mine the pitch. When the machinery comes out here, they have to be moving constantly. If they don't move constantly, they can sink. They then stockpile a pitch behind the refinery plant. So remember, that refinery plant is Trinidad and Tobago Lake Asphalt Company 1978 Limited. They stockpile it on either side of the buckets. They fill up the bucket, conveyor belt, it goes up the trestle or platform. The red tall tank, those are the boilers or still. If they put 180 tons of pitch in there, they would get back approximately 142 tons of asphalt. It's boiled for 16 hours. They use a steam heat of approximately 360 degrees Fahrenheit to 110 degrees Celsius. After it's been boiled, it's then strained in barrels. Those barrels weigh 524 pounds or 240 kilograms. The Brea takes it, it's then solidified. They then put them in containers and it's then exported out of our country to Germany, England, China, America, Canada, throughout the whole, throughout the whole wide world, mainly for road building and airport runway. They also make byproducts. They make records of cases of battery, Lasco coating, asphalt shingles, mastic, cement, flash bands, etc. When they're mining the pitch, they find artifacts out here, skeletons, skulls, animal bones, pieces of goblets out on the surface of the lake.
Goblets.
The Amerindians use those goblets to store their water. So in the earlier days, when the Amerindian ancestors die, they took them and threw them in the liquid. That is how they bury their ancestors and all their old material. Yes? Yes?
What happened to the light when the sun's come out?
It would be spongy. It would be softer than what it is right now. The rain fell, so it keeps it solid. Do you all have any questions?
Yes, when mining is taking place, you can bring visitors.
We stay away 100 meters away. We are not allowed to pass by the refinery plant.
Okay. Do you have mining on Monday?
Monday to Friday. They work, the mining of the pitch had been privatized. So the contractor would work 7 to 4 in the company that works on a shift base, 7 to 3, 3 to 11, 11 to 7. So they work every day and they avoid working weekends and holidays. Okay?
How long the pitch has been privatized? How long ago? The privatization.
The pitch, the mining of the pitch?
Yeah.
Yes. About 10 years now.
Was it necessary?
When I said privatized, meaning that they would give, at one time in Trinidad, they were privatizing everything, where they were letting contractors bid. And who bid the cheapest, they get a job. So the mining of the pitch, it had been privatized. Contractors are mining the pitch. The company is still state-owned. So in the company, they have their workers working on a shift base, okay? So when I said privatized, I mean the company. The mining of the pitch.
The mining is private, but the processing is government.
Yeah. So when you ask how long, about 10 years now. How long am? 30 years. Yes.
And concrete.
So it is not true. They say that asphalt is cancerogen.
Asphalt is refined. Pitch is raw. So when you use the term asphalt, you are not walking on asphalt, you are walking on pitch. Pitch have all impurities. This is why when I use the term asphalt, asphalt is refined. Remember when I said labor means pitch or asphalt? Pitch is raw, asphalt is refined. Asphalt is when it takes out all impurities. In the earlier days, in the 1600s, when Sir Walter Raleigh took back the pitch to England to show them what he called black gold, the first set of roads to be built in England were the roads in front of Buckingham Palace. But it was not holding the road firm. This is when the refinery plan was formed in the year 1888 by Mr. A.L. Barber and some other businessmen. But it was once run by the British. But it's no longer. It's now run by Trinidad and Tobago. So it's Trinidad and Tobago 1978 Limited.
I think the question he was asking though is whether either asphalt or pitch, the inhaling of the thing and handling it can give you cancer. That's
no, I had explained that.
I know, he didn't.
No, nothing happens to you. Nothing happens to you. Nothing happens to you. But some people get tired with asphalt and with pitch. Some people think that pitch and asphalt is the same thing. This is why I have to explain it over to make sure you understood what I was saying. Yeah, you have it. I want to show you all two more things. So let's go this way. But before we move, if you look at the pitch is in a hole. So every time they mine the pit, that gravitation pulls the village. You see that hill there? That hill is a landmark. The lake at one time was the same level of the road. A lot of people would say the pitch grow, but the pitch does not grow. It refills itself with the heat. How they had been mining the pit over the hundreds of years, it had decreased because they mine one spot 2 to 3 times. The heat from the sun, the heat from the pit dried out all the minerals in it. This is why you see the vegetation and the trees. And they are mining pitch out here. So the pitch does not grow. The pitch refills. And I don't think you all heard me when I was explaining. There are 3 lakes. One in Venezuela, Maracaibo, one in Los Angeles, La Brea Tarpet, and this one in Trinidad, which is a natural deposit, the 8th wonder of the world, the largest, and they use it mainly for road building and airport runway. The lake in Venezuela, Maracaibo, and the mother of this lake, they have underground communication. So if something sank in Venezuela, it turns up in Trinidad. If something sank in Trinidad, it turns up in Venezuela. But it's through oil vein. From mainland to mainland, we are approximately 7 miles or 11 kilometers away from each other.
Kind of like going to a factory when they make fire.
Can what?
The lake. Going to a factory.
No, when they send it into the refinery plant, they put it in the boilers, which is like pots. and they use a steam heat. No, it would not catch a fire.
Look at the birds.
Oil factory.
No. They don't have a refinery. Those are the vultures.
Oh, what?
Vultures.
The blackbirds.
So they were searching to see if any different predators.
Anybody sank in the liquid, they feeds on them.
Okay, okay.
Come this way, follow me.
Okay, I prefer
stay
to
stay with
you.
Me. This way. Okay, get it on better. Put it here with the gas.
Watch out this.
This is when it is semi-solid. This is when it's semi-solid. The pit refills itself. When they mine the pit, within 2 to 3 days' time, the heat and the pressure puts it up. So it refills and then replenish. This is what it looks like when it's replenishing. See all across there? It's go that way. You all go that way. Right, stay there. Don't step up. This is when it's replenishing itself. It comes up in a liquid state, it's semi-liquid, and it then solidifies, and it looks like here, and it's ready for mining.
Wood?
Yeah, this is a tree.
Human error?
Yeah. So you see, this is the petrified wood.
Petrified, eh?
See? So if you step in it, then you soil your shoes. You would not sink because this is replenishing itself. It's different to the mother of the lake or natural bitumen.
So I stay. What is that? This piece is not dirty in my hand. I thought.
Yeah. No, this is pitch.
Yeah, right, it's pitch.
Step up. Step up. Come this way.
Yes, sir.
Follow me, eh? Follow me. Go that way, miss. Hello, go that way. Just stay with my footstep. This is why I pass you all here. So you will get that experience.
It's running.
Look at the color of this water. Hear what I prefer. Come across.
Sulfur?
Come across. Come across. Across there is another thing.
Swim over, guys.
Come across.
Yeah, it's not this way. It's soft. You can feel it.
Very soft. But I wanted you all to get that effect. I wasn't thinking anybody. I just want you to go back with that memory.
Yeah.
Come across.
So when, if you want to bathe, which one do you want to bathe?
The ones that I'm showing you. Yeah, come across. Go ahead.
Where we put our feet is very soft.
Yeah, at this point here. Not across there. Here is much more softer, and this is what I want you to go back in your memory with, because in the dry season, that is how the lake will feel. Look at the color of this water. You see this one of green in it?
Yeah.
So because of the different minerals, the water would be of different colors. So I've shown you a pool which was brown, contain iron sulfide. This one contain carbon disulfide.
Those are the machines?
Yeah, the trucks of the machinery. You all have any questions? You all are on the surface of the lake, and this would be out there on the water on the lake. So do you all have any questions? But this is concentrated sulfur water because you actually see, you actually see the color. This one is different. Seen it? This contains iron. Now, in the dry season, this is what you would see. In the wet season, the water is diluted. You're not seeing the colors I'm showing you. It's lighter.
It's more water.
Yeah. You had a question, sir?
Is there any?
They can walk every day on it. The only time we cannot walk, on it to a point is where they are mining the pitch. We have to stay away 100 meters away from
the machines.
Yeah.
But if the sun gets real, real hot.
Very hot. When that sun is very hot, and you're walking out here, the pace we are walking at, you have to go faster, and you have to constantly move your feet when you are standing. That's the dry season when the sun, you see, if the rain hadn't fallen today, that's the effect you all would have get out here. That is why I pass you on this part of the lake. That is what it actually feels like when there are no rain.
So we have a beautiful
day. Yeah. And then if the sun was hot, we couldn't pass where we pass. Okay? So we'll be getting off the lake.
Could you identify the countries that you're representing today?
Yeah, Haiti,
Bahamas,
Belize, Honduras,
Barbados, Jamaica.
Guyana. Welcome. Welcome all the countries that we have in Trinidad. How long will you all be staying? How long will you all be staying?
9 days.
Okay. Is it the first time you all came to Trinidad?
Some of us.
Some? Okay. Had you all been able to go to any other parts of Trinidad or just this only site today?
Just this site.
Okay. Well, before you all leave, what I want you all to taste is the bacon shark. So if you all have time, go up to Marcus there and get some bacon shark. But where are you all staying?
We're in
Elbert,
South.
Well,
by
it's
Skinner
not
Park.
Really
by Skinner Park.
By Skinner Park. Okay. That's a, if you all go through in the course of the week early, it's about an hour. Hour and a half. You tasted before. And the hot sauce, how you all like it?
Yes.
Okay. So at this point, we'll be getting off the lake. So it's a pleasure meeting all of you. It's a pleasure having all of you on our island. Enjoy the rest of your stay in Trinidad. Have a blessed one. And I hope to see the faces again. When you come back to Trinidad, you come out here and take a swim. Yes, I travel. I went to St. Lucia, I went to Grenada, I went to St. Vincent, I went to Barbados. I didn't go to Jamaica yet. Jamaica is on my list, but I want to go camping this year. But it had some visitors who came earlier and they said the food is not nice in Cancun.
Yes, it is.
I don't know. They were saying.
Excuse me. Should we bring our swimming suit?
Yeah. When you come in to take a swim, yeah. You come with your swimming suit. Yeah? Yes, you would. When you get in this water, the water feels beautiful, your skin is smooth. It's like when you are swimming in St. Lucia in the summer pool. It's beautiful. You are welcome. It's my pleasure.
How long have you been doing it?
30 years. I'm a side tour guide and I'm a general tour guide.
Have there been any incidents in recent times?
Only in 1998, where the gentleman came out here, and in 2009, where three cows, three dogs, and came out here, stepped in the liquid, they died. Three cows and three dogs.
Food for the vultures.
Yep. And they couldn't save them because they had already meat to their stomach.
So the guy from the 1990s?
No, he's alive. They pulled guys and other villagers, pulled him out, washed him in kerosene, and then took him to the hospital. Yeah, kerosene is a byproduct of it. To take off the liquid from his skin. Oh, that's on the outskirts. Okay. Well, everything happens in a right timing. Okay. I live on the outskirts of Lavin. So therefore, you went and see the pitch point then. The pitch point. Where they used to dig the pitch. Okay.
I am.
So what country are you from?
Hmm?
What country are you from?
I was born here.
In Trinidad?
Yeah, but I lived all over the world.
Where you live? All over the world?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I lived in England, Nigeria, Botswana, Canada.
In Botswana, they had a cricket match in Botswana, it's not in the weaving boy. Is Botswana in the cricket match?
Yeah, Botswana and Zimbabwe. Mm.
We had a pan side there, providing the rhythm section.
Mm. Remember that, man?
Yeah.
Is West Indies play?
West Indies play, we play in South Africa. Right. And then we play Zimbabwe. In Zimbabwe. So when we get there, you have closing remarks, right?
Yeah, I'll do it under the tree.
Okay.
All right, David. I did a closing on the lake.
Yes, yeah, nice, thank you.
Yeah.
Final closure.
Yeah. We'll have another
dismissal.
Yes.
Okay. He didn't pick up that. He didn't pick up that whole, that part between both of us.
That was private.
I thought this was part of the closure because he started asking where we're from. So I thought that was kind of shortly after, thereafter.
I thought so too.
Yes. I meant to get that interjection for quite a while.
Okay. Ah.
I took that opportunity because she was saying, she was talking about next.
It was after you concluded that she started.
I took my cue from her.
She took her cue from you.
Yeah, both Trinidad yarns.
See, that's
Trinity
the bone. Trinity the bone. We think alike.
Yeah.
So you just want to put this group or include the other
people? Because we all on the same objective.
So I'll have to do that under the covered area then.
Mm-hmm. The red band and the green band.
Okay, well, I'll do it under the covered area.
Yeah.
Probably put back on your jersey. Put back on your jersey. The war closing remark at us.
All right, okay. No, nothing serious.
We doing it here or?
You tell me.
Seeing that they are here, let's do it here.
Okay, they're still coming.
Huh? Are you saying? Well, he did a documentary, so he's all over the world. Good afternoon again to everybody. On behalf of Beverly Taylor and Amina Hussein Clark, we would like to tell you all thank you for choosing this site, Labrapitch Lake. It's a pleasure meeting you all, and we look forward to seeing the faces again.
Thank you.
Months they would have the rainy season when the pools will be out.
Yeah, and so you could come and swim.
Yes. That's what I did.
She ain't picked up yet today. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Two.
China. Lake asphalt is used, I don't know if you are aware, it was used on the Buckingham Palace, the road in front of Buckingham Palace. It is used on the Autobahn in Germany. I am told that the Autobahn is a road that there is no limit to speed. You can go there and drive as fast as you like, and lake asphalt is used there. Lake asphalt has also been used recently on, I think, a 26-mile bridge in China. That went to connect two cities across, they use lake asphalt there. So we are the premium supplier of road building material. No other product could surpass our products. They are using polymers, they are using all other things to build roads, but lake asphalt has stand the test of time. So you are in a good place, home of the pitch lake. We welcome you from wherever you are, and we trust that your stay with us would be enjoyable for the time. I just want to let you all know, as it stands, where our facility, our washrooms are in this facility. It is just behind you all, on your right, the second and third door on your left. The second door on your left is male, the third door is the female. In case of any emergency, we have two emergency exits. We have the primary exit, which is behind on your left here. So this door, you just hit the bar, the door opens, and you go down the flight of stairs. Hold the rails, please, in case of any emergency. And the secondary muster point is just where you came in. So you go down the corridor, walk gently, not to run. I do expect that you will have, but it's just a briefing. You walk briskly, you hold the rails, you go down the step, You exit just as you came in, and you head across to where the Maxis are parked across there. That is our muster point, so we could have a head count of the people who came. So in case anybody, in case of emergency, is stuck in the building, we would be aware of, so we could do something in order to rescue them. Again, thanks for coming. We welcome you, and we trust that your afternoon will be enjoyable. I will also enjoy it, because I have turned my life to Jesus Christ, and I am glad to be in the midst of the children of God. So have a blessed evening and enjoyable time. I wish you also that you return back to your respective destinations in one piece, as God will have you. So bless and have a good time. Thank you.
With us this afternoon, we have already been entertained, but let me officially introduce to you, we have Mr. Tyrrell Marcel. Time and talent to come and entertain us for a few minutes, for a few hours here this afternoon. Also, Mr. Udman Caesar, who is a local Calypsonian. He is also a little refreshment, slight refreshments, which will be at the back. You all can get a box, take a drink, and we have persons there who will be handing out to you all, as you know, as you feel for the little water in the throat or a little bit something cool, right? So that will be at the back there. While you are being entertained, you can just, no formality, just help yourselves to the back. So I will now hand over back to Mr. Tyrrell Marcel. I think we had Sister Liddell and someone was going to do an item just now.
Yeah.
Okay, so you can now proceed with your item.
The land just off the Atlantic. Oh.
Angela Agar doing a very good job here.
Everybody, I'm not here to sing calypso. I'm just here to make a demonstration. And I'm going to ask somebody if they are daring enough to follow me, they can try. But I'm almost sure you can't do what I'm going to do. Ready? Alright, I have a coin here. I have a coin here in my hand. I'm going to put it on the edge of my elbow. And I'm going to catch it. Think I can do it?
The camera is going to capture it.
I don't know that you pop it because you didn't open your hand for me to see it.
Yeah, that's a good one. That's a good one. Alright, okay. Since you raised that, I'm going to add two. I don't put it here. Since you don't believe, I'm going to add three. I'm sure you think it is very easy. Last one. I'm going to add one more. And then I'm going to add somebody to try it. I have a volunteer. All right. See? Want to try? All right. I'm going to try the one. Ready? Let's try it one more time. You get in the hang of it? You can practice. Anybody else want to try? I'll tell you the truth. I'll tell you the principle behind it tonight. Well, I think you have exhausted your time. One more person. There must be somebody here who can outclass. Nobody? Oh boy. There must be a thing. You want to try?
No, I will.
All right, let me tell you what the principle is. Okay, the principle is that your elbow...
Wait first,
you have a challenger. Okay. I see you practicing down the back there. Let me see if it is a genuine card. Yes. All right. Yes.
Repeat.
Almost always when people do that, what they're trying to do is to catch the card and you drop it. But the principle is that your arm, your hand, is going to pass through the same space where the card is located. So all you have to do is just bring down your hand and it will catch it. So that's a pretty good. Thank you.
Travel again, right? So this guy traveled and he goes to Australia. And when he reached by immigration, right? Immigration told him he can't enter. However, they kept the guy watch. So he said, well, how come? Why you don't want me to enter? I want to keep my watch. You know the watch of a citizen.
Okay.
Yes, it prays. Always move on to my body, always better please. When in trouble, get down on you. She said, when you talk to the Almighty, the man they say is a tree. For you, you will always have sympathy.
Thank you.
or solving problems. And when Moses sat the Red Sea, his friends were do that for him. What's your sense in disaster? You just go to the master, waiting all your problems solved. Why I'm saying pray. Thank you. Marcel. I belong to the NG Seal of Nightingale, Seal Orchestra. I'm also the musical director. I came to do a performance here for the churches from along the Caribbean. It was very well. They have a very wonderful bunch of folks. Well, they are Christians, so they're supposed to be wonderful, and they were. Right. Any question, Mr. Meteorax?
How long have you been involved with PAN?
I've been involved with PAN from about 8 months. I'm 8 months old because I still haven't played in the christening. Yeah, I still haven't played at my christening, so I was involved. But I always admire the instruments. From around 6, 7, I started making my own pan with the free coating. I didn't know about notes, but grooving it with nails and people playing and enjoying it. Mm-hmm. Right? And then at the age of 9, I got my first tenor pan and I started playing. Right? In 1966 was my first year in Port of Spain. I played a little band called Hotspots. I was a member of the Liver Brothers, the Flamingos, the Exodus, the Vinyl Supersonic Soul of Brea, the Music Makers of Brea. I started in Brea. We had talented players, very talented players in Brea. As a matter of fact, Spirit Simon didn't really have pan in Brea. He said he discovered the pan. Right? Yeah. To my knowledge, Port of Spain had no oil fields, so where they get the drum from. So we started a whole history here, a lot of history that wasn't told because we live in a rural area. So you know the city and Port of Spain want to claim everything. So that is how it is. The steel band really come from South, most of the talented, the best tuners came from South.
Alan Jovi.
The Alan Jovi, the Leo Coca. Bertram Kelman, the name of few, from South. Mm-hmm. So if it had started in Port of Spain, I'm fellas would have been living in Del Monte and Avanti. Yeah, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah, so this is just a show. South, people just really underestimate the South. I think we have how many? 3 prime ministers? Is it true?
Well,
three prime ministers. We had
one woman, three men.
So like 4. Yeah. And we had 2 presidents.
Yeah.
So you see, I mean, we've been unfairly treated. The South is being unfairly treated. Just look at the statistics. The first person that got scholarship was our library. The pitch league, the first oil well. Well, I go back to PAN. Some people say the South Bands will be going down without being unfairly treated too. I mean, I have my take on that. But I know this going live. I hear what they're calling me and say, Terrell Marcel say that. Hey, but then they can say Terrell Marcel say that because I said it.
Okay. Terrell, there are a lot of young men rhyming on the block. Just nonchalant. If you had to send a message to them, what would it be?
If I had to send a message to the young men, try and do something that is progressive. There's a lot of courses that open up and they're giving you a stipend, and these young men just don't want to take it because they figure that we live in a lot of countries, so could you go to bed Friday night and Sunday morning you're a millionaire. But do something progressive. Join a steel band, join a cricket club, join a football club, sports. Instead of liming on the block with your 3 and 4 pants and the 3 below dirty, and you know you recognize that because you're sitting down with them 3 and all kind of thing. And when you walk in the streets, you feel it looking good.
Put down the guns.
Well, the guns is a different matter. The guns is beyond the young men and them on the block. The young men on the block, them can't import guns. That is a matter that beyond the young man, that higher. So these people higher about the sea water.
The 1%?
The 1% have the sea water. However you claim the percentage, they are the ones to see about it. Alright? And you can see that they're encouraging crime. Look, recently on the news, they caught a guy with so much cocaine. He went to court, he pleaded guilty to charge him $17,000. Yeah? Alright? Them fellas, the young people on the block, they watching these things. So what type of message you're sending? What type of deterrent you're sending to these young people? When they could sell a million and only pay 17,000. What sort of message
you're sending? Back on the street?
And they're back on the streets.
Same old, same old.
Yeah. I have a problem too with the officers. I don't have hard-working officers outside there. But strange enough, they're discovering so much guns and so much ammunition. Where is the perp? Where is the perpetrator? He just go in and get another supplies. He had to take off the street. His supplier, he had to take off the street.
So, how do you see yourself in the next, what, 4 or 5 years?
Well, I can't see myself in the next 4 or 5 years, I can tell you that. Try to live one day at a time.
Okay.
I presently am training some youngsters from Banshee School. I'm supposed to start from the Banshee School, and I also have a young group in our panel. And the more that we can develop them to something that is positive, they will always think positive. But this is lone friend who died, who was murdered. Always had to take a page from the book. He always said, Turn, try and push what is moving. That's right.
What about travels? How much have you done thus far?
I've done a lot of traveling. I go to Point 14, San Francisco. Fortunately, a year ago, we've been to Ghana.
You have been?
I've been to Ghana.
What part?
The Steelman have been to Ghana.
Oh, the Pantai.
The Pantai. They have been to Ghana, met some kings, and a lot of poverty, and a lot of nice, decent, educated people in Ghana. I'm surprised that we have so many educated people across. And that's what I have. What I have is the travel with the aeroplane. 8 hours in an aeroplane and then transit on an aeroplane.
You gotta leave south and head to northwest.
Yeah.
Then go across the east. Yeah. Then come back down.
Yeah. I admire the stay in London. I admire because I tell you what, 9 o'clock in the night, it was bright as day.
Well, depends on the season, eh?
Yeah, well, that's the season of it. So that's most travel to Ghana.
Yeah.
And that was a wonderful trip. Mm-hmm. Thank my sponsors, our minister, right? For allowing that to happen.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And the corporate government of Trinidad and Tobago. Right?
Yes.
Yeah, admire that.
All right, that was some beautiful music you put on there today.
Thank you. It came from the heart.
Heart.
Yeah. And you do something voluntarily, you have to do it with your heart.
Yes. Yeah, the people eating out of your hand.
Well, I know it's all their snack boxes.
We could expect more then.
Yeah, you could expect more. You people outside in chat. The good ones, keep on praying.
Mm.
A change will come. It will come.
Positively.
Yeah, it will come. It will come. To the hard-working policemen outside, keep on working. Have some of your peers trying to tarnish your image. Keep on working. Keep on working. It will come easy. Nothing comes easy.
At all.
All right,
enough respect.
Thank you.
Right?
Thank you.
We We also want to thank Mr. Terrell Marcel, who is the panelist. Our local Calypsonian, Mr. Oddman Caesar. I know there were a few delegates that came up and did their bit, so let us hear it for you. There was a gentleman greeting you at the door, all dressed. Also was at the bar, and we have our waitresses, Angela Hagar and Tadisha George. So I would like Reverend Edwards. I don't know if you have anything to say, but I would like him to close us off in prayer and also to pray for traveling nurses back to St. Mary. So let us welcome Reverend Edwards, Bishop Edwards,
and surprisingly, having lived in Labrador for 5 years, this is the first time I've been to the beach league.
Welcome back.
It is good to come back to Labrador. And I've always said that most of the things that I learned in ministry, I attributed to Labrie. This is the place where I first learned to preach in the open air. Most Sunday nights we had services in the open air. And this was the place that I also perhaps did the most pastoral work in my life. I knew all of the members and visited them quarterly. And this was a place where the church challenged me, and I also had the experience to develop as a minister. And I share with you one of the experiences I had here in that way, that perhaps was the most impactful experience of my ministry. There was a church here in Nagre, and it had, the membership was 65, but any Sunday morning you had more than 65 members. And one day I went to their leaders' meeting, and one of the ladies said to me, "Rev, we are going to paint the church for harvest." And it was a struggling church that never made the assessment. And I started to say, "What, sister?" And from the time I said "what," the lady, old lady, she jumped on her feet, and she said, "Rev, you see that pot? That pot is going to kill the church. Members, we are going to paint our church. But the text, what would it cost?" Said $640. And before my eyes, they collected $650. They collected $600. They pledged $600. And then they said, "The other $50, And they turned to my wife, "You'll take that from the food money and you'll put it members in this paint or collected the money before my eyes. $650. I've never forgotten that. And they painted the church house. And then, if you know me well, that I said, they challenged me. I need to challenge them as well. So the next year was mission. And San Fernando usually collect the most money, about $7,000 a mission. That way would usually collect about $3,000. And so I went to the meeting now, and I said to them, "Brothers and sisters, this year we're going to raise for mission $10,500. One brother said, "But Rev, that can't happen." The same lady got up on her feet and she said,
but Brother takes. Let us try now, let us try. And so we set out to raise $10,500 of mission, and what we did, we divided it into classes. And we gave each class $100. And they were supposed to meet, I think, about $1,200 each, something like that. And it became a very big secret among the classes as to what they were going to do. And then remember we had the meeting now at point 14, and Stuart, Sister Elmer, got up and she said, brothers and sisters, you know, library, things are very hard and very difficult, but we have tried, and we were able to raise 10,000, and nobody knew what 10,000 was. And the church raised 10,000 over 500 oxygen. And that's the place that I believe had an impact on the what, and then people were able to rise to that challenge and to raise the highest amount of money in the circuit for mission, which is $10,500. These are stories that I talk everywhere I go about my years in Africa, memory of the years, and it is good to be back in the South and back in Labre and to see the pitch league for the first time. And so in a sense, I can say to all of you, welcome to Labre. So freely bestowed upon your children. We give you thanks for the gift of friendship, for the gift of colleagueship, and for the memories that we share among your people. We give you thanks for the gift of nature, and for all that we were able to see and experience today as we visited the pitch lake. We stand, O God, amazed and marveled at your goodness, your handiwork, and so many things that we experience and yet we do not understand. We give you thanks, O God. We're thankful for those who were able to make this tour possible, and for those who enable us to share in this repast here in this place. We thank you for the tasty food and the smiles of those who served us lovingly. We give you thanks, O God. Amen. And now as we're about to leave to continue our journey, we pray for traveling mercies, that you may continue to journey with us. And so we pray for those who will drive the vehicles, that they may be guided by you in all things, and so that we arrive at our next destination safely. We also remember those who were not able to come to share this experience with us. We pray that wherever they may find themselves, that the same spirit that we share here may be with them. And now we commit them and we commit ourselves into your hands as we pray for your blessings continually, for Christ's sake.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I just would like to know if anyone here is from Grenada. And he wants to make a presentation as well to the young lady in green.
Nobody from Grenada.
Nobody here from Grenada.
Okay, no problem.
Grenada.
No, I'll go guys.
Thank you. Let us acknowledge we send a thank you to Mr. Harold Modeste in his absence. But he's here not. So on behalf of the delegates of the 39th Connectional Conference, I want to say thanks again to the Casper for their hospitality.
Thanks so much. More so to your country where you come from, and I trust that the pitchlink and the asphalt will be made mention wherever you come from.
Oh, yes.
We will expect in the near future to do some business with you all. I think that we are somewhere doing some business, I think with Guyana. I don't know how far that is, but again, thanks for thank you all for coming, and we wish you safe and support guided you back to your families. Listen, I've got a special for you all, but I see I thought you all were going to stay long.
Come back to you.
You come back to here. All right.